Now, while the birds thus sing a joyous song, and while the young lambs bound as to the tabor's sound, to me alone, there came a thought of grief. A timely utterance gave that thought relief, and again, I am strong.
My strongest memory from my cancer experience is the peace God gave to me in order for me to get through the ordeal. The experience has toughened me, tough enough to cope with the loss of my husband, son, brother, and mother. I was a homemaker and a dedicated nurse before breast cancer. I loved nursing, and because of that love, I often worked double shifts. I loved making my patients feel better. However, I had a hard time saying no. I was very much a yes person whenever I was asked to work extra shifts. Cancer taught me how to say no. I learned I had to take care of myself, especially if I wanted to continue to care for others. Following my recovery from surgery, I became very involved with volunteer work to help other cancer patients. Cancer survivorship has given me insight into what is and is not important as I travel this life's road. I do not waste time worrying about things I cannot control or being angry. Being angry took up too much of the life I have left. Life is way too precious to waste. It is far more important to use our lifetime in expression, Christian faith, loving those of importance in our life, and helping others who cross our paths along this journey. My mastectomy was in 1988. In 1994, I had a hysterectomy to increase my chances of life without a reoccurrence of cancer. As I waited for the surgery, I became afraid and began to worry. I prayed, "Please, God, don't let me have cancer again. I cannot go through chemotherapy again." I have often told others that God spoke to me through a ticker tape running through my brain over and over. "I was with you the first time, I will be with you again." My response was always, "I know, but it just seems to be you and me." These words kept going through my mind. The words eventually became a poem and then evolved into a song. I hope the song will help you as much as it has and continues to help me. Just you and me, Lord, when I'm feeling low. Just you and me, Lord, when I've no place left to go. When I feel the pain and tears fall down like rain, there's just you and me, Lord, just you and me. You are my comforter, you are my peace. I know I have a home on high, you've already signed the lease. So let me show my love as you do from above. There's just you and me, Lord, just you and me. You make my burdens light, oh Lord, you help me through each night. And when the morning breaks, you ease my heartaches. And when the sun goes down, darkness falling all around, there's just you and me, Lord, just you and me. So to all of you I say, when you kneel to pray, be assured you will find a great peace of mind. And don't forget that he can hold you tenderly. Hold me now, Lord, just you and me. Hold me now, Lord, just you and me.
Then sing ye birds, sing a joyous song, and let the young lambs bound as to the tabor's sound. We in thought will join your throng, ye that pipe and ye that play, ye that through your hearts today feel the gladness of May.
Hi, I'm breast cancer.
And I'm thyroid cancer.
Yep, that's us. BNT.
Why do you come first?
Because B comes before C.
What's C got to do with
That's
it?
That's why we're here, the big C.
Oh, that reminds me of a story.
What story?
Have you heard the one about the head of oncology?
No.
Well, he was this tightwad, you know. He rarely did anything for his wife. When he died, she tried to sell his body to science. But she went to a brain store to see what they were going for. And she looked around a bit. Nurses' brains were $20 a pound. Doctors' brains were $30 a pound. But the department head brains retailed for $500 a pound. She got real excited.
Well, that didn't seem right.
Well, sure it does. Think about it. Do you know how many department heads' brains it takes to make a pound of brains?
Good point. Speaking of shopping, don't go to Walmart.
I wasn't talking about shopping.
Yes, you were. You were talking about brain stores and stuff and selling body parts and anything. Well, anyway, stay away from Walmart.
Why?
Well, because you go get in your car and this young man, nice looking young man, cutie pie, comes up and offers to clean your windshield for you.
I don't like that.
And the next thing you know, he is stripped down to his waist and he's there just wiping your window with this young hard body. And then his friend comes up to do the other side of your car. Calm down, Eve. And he comes up and he strips down too. And then you got these two hard bodies there just cleaning your windshield.
I'm going tomorrow.
And this guy comes up, the third guy, and he goes in your back seat and he steals your pocketbook.
That's awful.
I know. I know. It's terrible. Happened to me 5 times last Saturday.
You're awful. You're awful.
Yeah, I know it. I know it. Cancer made me this way.
Cancer didn't have a thing to do with it.
Yes, it did. It taught me that it's okay to be silly and stupid and to laugh a lot because life is short. So soak it.
True.
Soak it so that you can leave it yelling, "Yee-haw, girl, what a ride!"
What though the radiance which was once so bright be now forever taken from my sight? Though nothing can bring back the hour of splendor in the grass, the glory of the flower, we will grieve not, rather find strength in what remains behind, in the primal sympathy which having been must ever be, in the soothing thoughts that spring out of human suffering, in the faith that looks through death, in years that bring a philosophic mind. And oh, ye fountains, meadows, hills and groves, forebode not any severing of our loves. Yet in my heart of hearts, I feel your might. I only have relinquished one delight to live beneath your more habitual sway. I love the brooks which down their channels fret, even more than when I tripped as lightly as they.